disciplined based on the respondent's conviction for conspiracy to commit health care fraud in the United States District Court for the Northern District of Texas, Dallas Division. We filed our petition for compulsory discipline on May the 24th, 2018. On July 24th, 2017, the respondent was charged by superseding information with count one, conspiracy to commit health care fraud in clause number 315-CR-409-M, styled in the United States of America, Mr. Tshombe Anderson, in the United States District Court for the Northern District of Texas, Dallas Division. On May 9th, 2018, a judgment in a criminal case was entered, 315-CR-00409-M1, styled the United States of America, versus Tshombe Anderson, wherein the respondent pled guilty to conspiracy to commit health care fraud and was committed to the custody of the Bureau of Prisons for 10 years. Upon release, he will be on supervised release for 3 years. It is further ordered to pay restitution in the amount of $26,572,458.93. Now, approach. This time, the Commission would offer the following exhibits. Exhibit 1 is a certified copy of the superseding information in the underlying criminal case. Exhibit 2 is a judgment in that criminal case. Exhibit 3 is my original affidavit attesting to the fact that Mr. Anderson is the same. I see who's the attorney. This matter is the same as the defendant in the underlying criminal case. Exhibits 4 through 8 are certified copies of prior discipline. Exhibit 4 is a judgment of partially probated suspension in cause number D00304-23209 entered on March 2, 2005. Exhibit 5 is a default judgment of partially probated suspension in cause number D20903-22019 and D21003-22290 July 6, 2005. Exhibit 6 is an agreed judgment of partially probated suspension in cause number D00705271194 entered on November 7, 2006. Exhibit 7 is an agreed judgment of public reprimand in cause number D00606299906 entered on November 11, 2007. Exhibit 8 is an agreed judgment of partially probated suspension in cause number D00310396111 and D00310396644 entered on October 18, 2011. And Exhibit 9 is the original certification from Blake A. Hawthorne, clerk of the Supreme Court of Texas, dated July 9, 2019, indicating that respondent is licensed but not currently authorized to practice law in the state of Texas. We would offer those at this time. Thank you. We refer Mr. Anderson is currently incarcerated in Beaumont, Texas, and we seek a judgment of disbarment.
Mr. Perry, I note that he pled guilty and the judgment is May of 2018. Are you certainly no appeals?
No, sir. There's no appeals.